Hi everyone, it's Michelle Powell with Some Like It Organized. Today I'm with Allegra Ramos from emberliving.com. She's also a wife, mom, entrepreneur of several businesses, including a successful online store. So I'm sure everyone is wondering, how do you do it?
Well, I wouldn't say I'm the most organized person in the world, but I am pretty good at containing chaos.
There you go.
Yeah, so you know, it's all about finding a place for things and having a place to shove stuff when people are coming over.
Well, that's the thing. So first, what systems do you use then at home to keep your whole family organized?
Well, I have a few strategies that I employ. One of them is scan and put away. So anytime I'm leaving a room and going to another room, I scan the room and see if there's something I can grab to take to that other room I'm going to. And this is really important with kids because they will spread out and take over your entire space if you let them. So I'm always scanning a room and looking for toys that I can walk back to my daughter's room.
Nice.
And some other things that I do, no one wants to think about where does the ugly stuff go. But there's always going to be things that you need to put in their place. So for instance, I have a bin for household hazardous waste. So that is batteries that have expired. Mm-hmm. I always use rechargeable batteries, by the way. That's for medicines that have expired. That's for light bulbs that have burnt out. So I have a bin in my garage that is designated for household hazardous waste. So I have a place to collect it before I take it to the city to be disposed of properly.
I love that.
So it's important to have that. Another thing that I have is I have a bin for household projects.
Okay.
Because last time we cleaned out our garage, we found literally so many tubes of caulk and wood glue that we were able to fill a box this big with it. Because every time we did a project, do we have enough caulk? I don't know. Do we have enough wood glue? I don't know. So we buy it.
Perfect.
So now we have a designated bin for any projects that we've purchased the supplies for but haven't done it, and it sits in that bin. And then when I know we're gonna do a project, we can go and see what supplies we've purchased already.
This is great. You know, I tell people sort of a bin for outgoing materials like, you know, dry cleaning or whatever, but this goes a step beyond, so that's wonderful.
Well, there's always things to do around the house. Another one of my strategies is to put things that you're gonna use daily in easy access. And it's so funny because we can just be on autopilot that we don't think about how to optimize our spaces. And I'm always thinking about how I can optimize my space. So when I recently reorged the laundry room, I said, why are the rags on the second shelf?
Yes.
Which means me, I'm not that tall, have to, you know, strain to get them. And I said, there is the space that is currently on the first shelf, yes. I don't use that stuff at all. So guess what? I made that easy switch and it makes my life just much easier. So I always put, if I'm gonna use it daily, it's out or it's on the first shelf. So in my kitchen, that means my blender, my Vitamix, and my Hurom juicer, they're on the counter. My KitchenAid, which only gets brought out for special occasions, is high up in far away storage, okay? So daily use means first shelf or easily accessible. If I'm gonna use it semi-regularly, then it can be in the house. And if it only gets used a handful of times a year, then it's in the garage.
So then, as an ecotastic role model, what are some real life tips to stay minimal or avoid overconsumption?
Well, I have a number of strategies. One of them is we have a rule in our house that if we can't park in the garage, it means there's too much stuff. So we have always been able to park in our two cars in our garage, and anytime we acquire something, say a stroller or something, and we have to pull out of the garage, well then it means that we either have to remove some things or we need to find a place to store that new item. So that's one thing. You know, you kind of have to set limits for yourself. You know, another thing I have with my closet is if I purchase something, I actually will hold it. And I will wear anything that I have that's kind of similar to it for that following week. And then at the end of the week, I'll determine, okay, is this different enough that I'm gonna add it to my wardrobe? If so, maybe I need to get rid of something that's maybe a little frayed or dated or whatever. But if it's too similar, maybe I don't really need it and I just wanted it in that moment.
I love that.
Because one thing people don't, you know, people don't realize, like we have a lot of chemical reactions going on in our body. And rather than fight them, come up with these strategies. So I don't know if you know this, but when you purchase something, you actually get a little hit of dopamine, which is part of why people get addicted to it, because dopamine's like the love drug. Like, oh, it feels good, oh, it feels good. So I get affected by that. Like, I can't control my chemistry. So when I see something pretty that I want, I will buy it. I get that dopamine hit. But after a week, the dopamine's gone and I'm more logical and I can determine, do I really need or want this?
I love that.
And I just, if I don't need or want it, then I'll return it.
You know, that really goes along with my organizing values because I'm all about reevaluating later on. So it's not just about, let's get organized and that's it. You have to continue to reevaluate.
Right.
Is this still serving me? Do I still love it? Is this needed in my home? That's awesome.
Yeah, there's no destination. It's always about the journey towards optimizing, I mean, in my opinion. Another thing that I do is anything I can borrow, I don't purchase.
Right.
And then finally, I eat very repetitively. And you might wonder, how does this help you minimize waste? Well, a lot of people, you know, try to keep it so jazzy and different every single day, like eating repetitively is boring.
Mm-hmm.
But then a lot of times you end up buying more than you need because maybe you're not familiar with that recipe and you buy too much, or you don't like it as much as you thought you would, and then you end up throwing away. So I really find that by eating repetitively, one, it makes it easy for our family to eat healthier. It cuts down on time that I spend like trying to figure out a new recipe. And I can literally go into the grocery store and buy exactly what we need, and we throw almost no food away. There's almost no waste, no leftovers, because we do eat so repetitively. And then on special occasions, we'll do something special, but.
So what does that mean exactly, eat repetitively? What's happening at the store?
We literally eat almost the same thing every day, Monday through Friday.
Okay.
So the same thing for breakfast, the same thing for lunch.
Mm.
And dinner is different every night, but like Thursday night is eggs and toast night.
Mm-hmm.
It just always is. So I always make sure that we have eggs and toast for that.
Okay.
So it just means that I can go into the grocery store and I know every week we need 4 bunches of kale. We need one bunch of carrots.
Okay.
We need one bunch of celery, one bunch of romaine.
Mm-hmm.
We need 2 dozen eggs. We need 1 loaf of bread. I mean, literally every single week I buy almost the exact same thing.
So it really simplifies that whole process.
Okay, it simplifies the shopping process, the cooking process. There's less waste.
Love it.
And also keeps us, you know, eating healthy.
Yes. So what about all the work that comes with running multiple businesses? What are some key success strategies that you can share with us?
Well, first of all, you do have to prioritize, like with all things in life. And all of my businesses are very different stages.
Right.
The oldest business is 10 years old, whereas I have one that I've just been building in the last 14 months. So it's really clear to me where I'm gonna spend my time because obviously the new one needs more of my attention and more of my time. So you have to prioritize. For the business that I'm working on growing, I just have a simple rule of, have I done at least 2 things today to move that forward? Sometimes, especially as a working mom, it can be easy for Monday through Friday to be, you know, family, kid time, and then try and like squeeze things in on the weekend. But you're just not really going to build up the momentum that you need. And it's going to be like you're having to get back into, oh, I have to put my business hat on.
Right.
Whereas for me, my business hat and my daily life hat and my mom hat, they're just, they're all together.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just do a little bit every day to help move things forward. And things might not move as fast as I would like them to, but I'm aware of that trade-off that I've made choosing to be a really, you know, hands-on mom and wife and everything.
I hear the acceptance in that as well. I'm gonna point that out. So you're accepting that you can't do it all fast, like,
right,
as you want it, but you're still getting things done.
So exactly, that's awesome. Exactly. And then finally, really eating repetitively, which I talked about as one of my tools for minimizing waste, that also just helps to free up a lot of time. And coincidentally, or maybe not coincidentally, eating repetitively also helps us to make sure we're eating healthy, you know, because I don't have to rethink how can we eat healthy today and eat something new and spontaneous. So making the choice to eat repetitively also allows me to free up my time to spend my mental energy and my time energy on what's more important to me, which is building my business.
Valuable resources, right?
Yes, yes. You have to figure out how to spend that because it is, you only have so much time, you only have so much bandwidth, and how are you going to spend that?
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for being here. And if the readers want to learn more about you, how can they find you online?
You can go to emberliving.com, where I have a blog, and I also have links to my online store and to my video series that I did with Howcast, which is available on YouTube. I have a series of 50 green living videos. They're very, very basic for the completely newbie, although there are a few more advanced topics. And you can find it all at emberliving.com.
Perfect. Thanks so much for being here, and we'll see you next time.